Is Mr. Grover in his office?
Yes, just a moment. Miss Phelps would like to see you. He'll be right out.
Thank you.
Don't forget.
Oh, Mr. Grover, this is Wolf J. Flywheel.
How do you do?
That's rather a personal question, isn't it, old man? How I do and what I do is my concern. And if you marry me, your concern will be my concern.
I've just hired Mr. Flywheel as a floor walker.
Oh, Martha, we have enough floor walkers.
Oh, please.
Well, however, if you desire, what experience have you had in a department store?
I was a shoplifter for 3 years.
Oh, and Mr. Flywheel likes his little joke. Just tell Mr. Grover what experience you've had.
Do you object if I ask him a few questions?
Oh, not at all.
Go right ahead. Ask her anything you want.
Well, it's you that I'm asking the questions.
Well, I just heard you ask her if you could ask me a few questions.
Well, just a minute.
After all, I'm not blind. Oh.
We will assume that I am a customer. I'm returning a baby carriage.
Are you married?
Why, of course not.
Then what are you doing with a baby carriage? This man's a cad. A yellow cad.
Why, the whole thing is utterly ridiculous. Now, I'll ask you a simple question. It's bargain day. The store is crowded. A woman faints. What do you do?
How old is she?
What difference does it make?
You hear that? A woman's life is in danger, and he asks, what difference does it make? And that charlatan is running your store? Martha, I'd fire him immediately.
If Miss Phelps were not my fiancé, I would tender my resignation and walk out of this store for good.
Oh, no, no.
Fiancé?
Yes.
Do you mean that a woman of your culture and money and beauty and money and wealth and money would marry that imposter? Just a moment. What's the idea of prowling around here?
Why, that's Tommy Rogers.
Oh, how are you, Tommy?
No, I'm Tommy Rogers.
Oh, well, how are you, Tommy?
How do you do?
I'm a Ravelli. I'm Tommy's bodyguard.
You're Tommy? I'm Tommy's bodyguard. I've just been engaged.
You'll excuse me.
So you've been engaged, eh?
Of course. Here's my $5 deposit to prove it.
Well, keep it the $5. I'll guard Tommy for nothing.
Scab.
I heard that.
So you're not a floor walker. You're a so-called bodyguard. What does this mean, Martha?
Well, I felt Tommy needed a real experienced detective to safeguard him, so I,
So naturally, she hired me, the greatest detective since Sherlock Holmes.
I'm crazy about Sherlock Holmes.
It won't do you any good. He's got a wife and 3 kids.
So this man is a detective?
Yes.
Huh.
Mr. Flywheel.
Just call me Wolf.
Now that you've revealed yourself, you spoiled everything. And after you promised not to tell.
How could I keep from telling the world of you and your beauty and my feelings about you? She walks in beauty like the night of cloudless climes and starry skies.
Why, that's Byron.
He was thinking of you when he wrote it.
Wolf, do you remember this? Thou friend whose presence on my wintry heart fell like bright spring upon some herbless plain.
Shelley?
Shelley.
They're not writing that kind of stuff anymore. Here's a little something to you. Your eyes so blue, your heart so true. Your lips divine, say you'll be mine.
Wolf, where did you ever learn to write such beautiful poetry?
I worked 5 years for Boehmershave.
What is this man? A detective, a floor walker, or a poet?
All three. And not bad at making love, eh, Martha?
Woo-hoo.
I can't stand this any longer, and I won't stand it.
Just a moment, Mr. Grover. If my aunt wants this man to be my bodyguard, it's okay with me. Mr. Flywheel, my life is in your hands.
I wouldn't be happy here. I'm not appreciated.
Not appreciated? Why, I think you're great.
What do you really think of me?
Well, I think you're wonderful.
Do you? Do you think I'm any good?
Man, you're terrific.
How am I? All right?
Want to know? You're sensational.
I could listen to this man forever. And now, if you don't mind, Martha and I would like to be alone. Scram!